Skyblock has been around for over a year now, and when any game is in any prototype-like state for so long, countless glitches and unfinished features are bound to be around, and so far, the Skyblock admins have been relatively nice with leaving the totally harmless glitches in the game and not forcefully removing them. So today, I'm going to cover some of the unfinished features and glitched items that have emerged throughout Skyblock's development period. Ah yes, wanna be in the swag under 50k gang? Then go subscribe right now. Also, I'm gonna be doing not one, but two AUTD giveaways in our Discord server, discord.gg/duo, link in the description. Anyways, first of all, placeable backpacks. Placeable head items are nothing new in Skyblock. If it's a head item, there's a good chance that someone out there has a placed version of it. Even though I have a lot of placeable pufferfish baits on my island, and this mad lad has a whole lot of placeable coins and Steve heads, and this guy called Fastnash with an entire museum of every glitched and or placeable head item in the game, and while all of these have their own backstories, two placeable head items remains the most elusive of them all: placeable emperor skulls and placeable backpacks. Although there does not appear to be any placeable emperor skulls around, it is known that 32 purple placeable backpacks exist, and they are very rare. They cannot be used to store items, but can be placed inside other backpacks. It is unknown how they were created. The Nether Star is an item dropped by the Wither Boss, but there is no Wither Boss in Skyblock. It has a legendary rarity, so it has clearly some intention to exist in Skyblock, and will have some use in the future, probably dropped from Necron in dungeons. Players could achieve this by dropping a catalyst out of the bazaar menu when a bot caused players to be able to drop them on the floor and pick them up. The future of this item is unknown. The Eternal Crystal is one of the only items to be fully removed from the game. Added on Skyblock's release, the item combined the effects of the Night Crystal and Day Crystal into a permanent +5 strength and +5 defense, and was crafted using a Night Crystal and a Day Crystal. If you've ever used the Talisman Optimizer bot, you'll be familiar with this item, as it tells you that you're missing it when it does not exist. There are only two known players to own one, Super Tier and Plank, both getting theirs in the first half of June. Whether Super Tier was one of the only early game players to get High Quartz Collection before the Bazaar release, or something completely different, we may never know. Shoutouts to Joshius for sharing this mystery with me, and he plans to make a video on his channel to get the bottom of this and other mysteries, so you should go check him out. The Wizard Portal in the Wizard Tower has existed forever, and yet it does absolutely nothing. When trying to enter the portal, he asks you to give him 2 to 5 business days to fix it, and I'm sorry to inform you, but it's currently been 12 to 13 business months. Whether it goes to some dungeon's place, new islands, or fanboy hooters, nobody really knows. Similarly, the giant portal behind the mountain has been out of action since the start and has only ever been mentioned once in the release notes of Skyblock telling you it's something related to guilds, but this also does not appear to have been worked on at all. Share some more glitched items or unsolved mysteries you know of in the comments, and if there's enough cool ones, we might do another video about this in the future.